So I've asked Christina Peck to share with you a little bit about getting the most from the Booking Blitz, because she's participated in the first two that we've done in this past summer, and she's had some killer success. So I asked her if she would just share with you a little bit.
Perfect.
So
I've done many Booking Blitzes in the past with other companies, and I've done a lot of researching on my own outside of home-based business trainings and read books and stuff and got a lot of the different ideas. And when she said Booking Blitz, I said, oh, I'm all over that. So what I did was I made a list of 30 people, because you know, they say if you want 10, you make 50. If you want 20, you add 60. So I did 30. My goal was to at least get 10. So what I did is I went to my messenger, the people that I talk to every day in my messenger, and I wrote down 30 people in there. And I wrote out this blurb, would you be willing to do a Tupperware party with me, blah, blah, blah. And I copied and pasted it, but every time I copied and pasted it, I personalized their name, and I added another blurb in there of something I knew about them to make it more personal. And two ladies are on here tonight as my team members because they are victims of my blitzes. So I'm going to tell you that right now. Well, actually three. And then I didn't get very many responses back. And I got, some of them didn't even check their messenger. And then I got about 9 to 12 yeses, and I got 6 no's. But remember, I did 30 people, so I wanted all 30 responses, but I only got about 12 and 6, so that was about 18. Then I realized, oh, I can win $100. I'm gonna send my message to a few more people the next day because my time limit wasn't up, and I got a few more responses, but they were no's. So I submitted my results into Tina, and I was really shocked that I won. I was really surprised. I thought that was a very low number. I'm like, well, maybe not a lot of people are participating. So the second blitz came up, and I thought, well, you know, I've already won once. I'm going to let other people have a chance. So my goal changed. I wanted the responses this time instead of the yeses. So I came up with this simple little piece of paper that has this written on it. And I put my finger here because this is where I wanted their attention to go, the word Tupperware. And I snapshotted myself, not looking like this, but I snapshot myself like this, right? And I didn't send any words in my message. I just sent this picture. And it says, will you host a Tupperware party with me or for me? And it says free, free, free. And I decorated it up. I just made this up tonight, but it didn't look any better than this. And I sent that picture out, and I got 18 responses back. A lot of them were yeses and a few of them were no's. And then the other two came the next day, but they came after my time limit, which was fine, but that totaled up 30 responses. And here's my list. As you can see, I took all my notes on my list here. This is for one blitz, this is for another blitz. So I wrote out their names, I sent them the picture. Some of them sent back, oh, you're funny, but guess what? That was a response. Or, yes, I will, silly girl. Or, no, not right now. And then I used Tina's no, not right now. No, not now, or no, not never. And I got some responses back saying, not right now, but maybe in October. So guess what? They are on my list for October. But guess what? They're going to be even happier because now they have all these specials, right? So then I went in, and as soon as they said yes, I went in and put in their information and their phone or their emails and got their party ready in the back office. So now I can go back to my back office and go, okay, this party hasn't started yet. and then go set up their Facebook party for them and invite them when we're ready. And I have everything set up ahead of time. So just that simple picture. And I actually learned that from Amanda Todd, which Tina references sometimes on booking trainings and party trainings and stuff like that. So again, that was like a off to the side training that I took on my own by researching. But yeah, just, you know what, be silly. That grabs attention. Like I said, it was just this little piece of notebook paper and a smile, and it got everybody's attention. It made them laugh. It made them giggle. It made them respond. And because the first time I was pretty hurt, these are the people I talk to every day and they didn't respond back to me. The second time my 30 list came from my newsfeed, I thought, okay, I'm not getting responses back from people I talk to every day. So let me go to my newsfeed with all those people that interact with me every day in my newsfeed. And I jotted down 30 people from that. And this time I'll be going to not complete strangers, but people that have friended me through either a vendor event or a personal party or one of their parties or a friend you may know. That comment on my stuff, or, you know, I've been talking to them here and there. So this is my third market of friends. My first one was my warm. My second one was my medium. My third one is my not so warm market. So wish me luck. I wish you all luck. I challenge every one of you to beat my score. I really want to see you doing it. I really would love to see all of you guys commenting, party, 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 yay, yay, yay. I really love seeing that. I love seeing everybody else's success. And let's rock this one out, you guys, and just be you and have fun with it. Have fun with it.
Thank you so much, Christina.
You are welcome.
You know, I was